Agricultural pests. Pest refers to any animal or plant causing harm or damage to people or their animals, crops or possessions, even if it is only cause annoyance. Pests belong to a broad spectrum of organisms including insects, mites, ticks and other arthropods, mice, rats and other rodents, slugs, snails, nematodes and other parasites, weeds, fungi, bacteria, viruses and other pathogens. Productivity of crops grown for human consumption is at risk due to the incidence of pests, especially weeds, pathogens and animal pests. Crop losses due to these harmful organisms can be substantial and may be prevented or reduced by crop protection measures. An overview is given on different types of crop losses as well as on various methods of pest control developed during the last century. Estimates on potential and actual losses despite the current crop production practices are given for wheat, rice, maize, potatoes, soybean and cotton for the period 2001 and 2003. On a regional basis as well as for the global total. Among crops, the total global potential loss due to pests varied about 50% in wheat to more than 80% in cotton production. The responses are estimated as losses of 20 to 29% for soybean, wheat and cotton and 31, 37 and 40 for maize, rice and potatoes respectively. Overall, weeds produced the highest potential loss, 34%, with animal pests and pathogens being less important, losses of 18 and 16%. The efficacy of crop protection was higher in cash crops than in food crops. Weed control can be managed mechanically or chemically, therefore worldwide efficacy was considerably higher than for the control of animal pests or diseases which rely heavily on synthetic chemicals. Regional differences in efficacy are outlined. Despite a clear increase in pesticide use, crop losses have not significantly decreased during the last 40 years. However, pesticide use has enabled farmers to modify production systems and to increase crop productivity without sustaining the higher losses likely to occur from an increased susceptibility to the damaging effect of pests. Aphids, also known as plant lice, and in Britain and the Commonwealth as green flies, black flies or white flies, are small sap-sucking insects and members of the superfamily Apidoidea. Aphids are among the most destructive insect pests on cultivated plants in temperate regions. Their success is due in part to the asexual reproductive capabilities of some species. About 4,400 species of 10 families are known. Historically, far fewer families were recognized, as most species were included in the family Aphididae. Around 250 species are serious pests for agriculture and forestry as well as an annoyance for gardeners. They vary in length from 1 to 10 millimeters. Natural enemies include predatory ladybirds, hoverfly, parasitic wasp, aphid midge larvae, crab spiders, lace wings, and entomopathogenic fungi like Lacanicillium lacani and the entomopatheroles. The brown plant hopper, BPH, Nila Parvata lugens, Homoptera delpacidae, feeds on rice plants Oryza sativa. BPH are among the most important pests of rice, and rice is the major staple crop for about half the world's population. They damage rice directly through feeding and also by transmitting two viruses, rice raged stunt virus and rice grassy stunt virus. Up to 60% yield loss is common in susceptible rice cultivars attacked by BPH. The BPH are distributed in Australia, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Burma, Cambodia, China, Fiji, India, Indonesia, Japan, North and South Korea, Laos, Malaysia, Nepal, Pakistan, Papua New Guinea, Philippines, Sri Lanka, Taiwan, Thailand and Vietnam. Their host plant other than rice is Lyrisia alexandra. Coming to the biology, the brown plant hopper is dimorphic with fully winged Macropterus and truncate winged Brachopterus forms. The Macropterus forms are potentially migrants and are responsible for colonizing new fields. After settling down on the rice plants, they produce the next generation in which most of the female insects develop as brachophytes and males as Macropterus. Adults usually mate on the day of emergence and the females start laying eggs from the day following mating. Brachypterus females lay 300 to 350 eggs, while Macropterus females lay fewer eggs. The eggs are thrust in a straight line generally along the mid region of the leaf sheath. Eggs hatch in about 6 to 9 days. The newly hatched nymphs are cotton white and turn purple brown within an hour. They feed on plant sap. They undergo 5 instars to become adults. Rice varieties with resistance to BPH, examples IR64, are important for preventing outbreaks. However, in areas with low insecticide use, high levels of BPH resistance are not usually necessary. In attempt to make BPH control more species specific, researchers are trying to develop methods of tuning of specific BPH genes for digestion, defense and xenobiotic metabolism. Many novel genes of these functions have been detected in tissue from BPH intestines. Some plant lectins are antifreedants to BPH, and if properly formulated, many have the potential to protect rice from BPH. The coffee berry borer, Hypothymus hempi, is a small beetle native to Africa. It is among the most harmful pests to coffee crops across the world where coffee is cultivated. Some Spanish common names of the insect includes Bernardar del Café, Grogada del Café and Broca del Café. The larvae is white with a brown head and a length of 0.7 to 2.0 millimeter and a width of 0.2 to 0.6 millimeter. Females have 2 larval stages and males only 1. They have strong mandibles and their larval phase lasts 10 to 26 days. The pupae are yellowish with a length of 0.5 to 1.9 millimeter. The adults are small black beetles. Females are 1.4 to 1.8 millimeter long. The males are smaller, 1.2 to 1.6 millimeter long. Female beetles can fly short distances. Males have no wings. Females have 4 to 6 teeth in the frontal margin of the pronotum. The maturation of the insect from egg to adult lasts between 24 to 45 days, varying according to the weather. Usually the female drills the berry through the central disc, although it can enter through the disc walls if the fruit is dry. 2 days after the ashes, the beetle lays 35 to 50 eggs, which produce 13 females for each male. The lifespan for females is 35 to 190 days and for males 40 days. The new insects mate inside the seed. Some females lay the eggs in the same coffee plant, others colonize new ones. The males never leave the fruit. The distribution of the pest corresponds to the entire area of coffee crops. The accidental transport of contaminated seeds is believed to be the cause. The insect was native of Angola and spread to the rest of Africa during the 1920s. The first reports in America were in Brazil. In the 1970s, it affected Guatemala and Mexico. Control. The presence of the insect affects the economy of over 20 million families that depend on the coffee harvest. It has caused marked reduction in the species of coffee, reducing the sale price to growers. The beetle can destroy the entire harvest of an area. The main measure against the pest are preventative. The application of efficient control programs is difficult since the coffee plant is perennial with several flowering periods and grows in areas with very unpredictable weather. Prevention. Prevention is based in the careful inspection of the coffee beans before leaving the coffee fields to avoid spreading of the insects. Also, a number of border controls has been established in countries with coffee crops. Chemical control. Insecticides are useful only before the female beetle penetrates the berry. There are reports of resistance to endosulfan in New Caledonia. Biological control. During the time when beetle offspring emerge from each commercially ruined berry to disperse, they are vulnerable to predation. The yellow warbler, rufous-capped warbler, and other insectivorous birds have been shown to reduce by 50% the number of coffee berry borer beetles in Costa Rica coffee plantations. Parasitoids. The parasitoids used to control the borer beetle are Hymenopteran wasps, native to Africa. Although they have a low impact in the beetle population, the use of biologic control allows the product to qualify as organic food. Bithylid parasitoids. Bithylidae. Cephalonomica staphandoris, Bitterum and Propus noestia watson are introduced in some Latin American countries from Africa during the 1980s and 1990s. With low success in the late 1990s, the C. hylampinus native of North America was described as attacking the boar beetle in Chiapas, south of Mexico. This species preys on the eggs of H. hempi. Another useful bitelid is Sclerodermus cadavericus, but its management is difficult since it is an aggressive wasp and can cause severe dermatitis. Ulophid parasitoids. Ulophidae. Pymasticus coffee was discovered in Togo in 1987. It attacks the adult beetle and mass rearing in Colombo has been successful. It has a capacity to stay in coffee crops for a long time. Braconid parasitoids. Braconidae. Heterospilus caffeicola was observed in Uganda, but its reproduction in laboratories has been unsuccessful. Ants. Hymenoptera formicidae are the main predator of H. hempi. However, the research of the Centro Nacional de Investigadores de Café, Cinecafé, Colombia, reported other insect families implicated in the predation, Anthrocradidae, Hemiptera, and Quiquidae, Coleoptera. These are the genus and species that have been reported to attack the borer beetle, Formicidae, Solenopsis, Fidolia, Wasmania, Paratrichinia, Crematograster, Bracamyrmix, and Prenolepsis. Plutola xylostella, sometimes called cabbage moth, is a European moth believed to originate in the Mediterranean region that has since spread worldwide. The moth has the short life cycle, 14 days at 25 degrees Celsius, is highly fecund and capable of migrating long distances. It is one of the most important pests of cruciferous crops. However, not all of these plants are equally useful as host to the moth. There has been some discussions of using winter scissors as a buffer plant around agricultural fields, as diamondback moths are highly attracted to that plant, but their eggs fail to survive when oviposited on it. The diamondback moth lays its eggs only on plants in the family Brassicaceae. Nearly all cruciferous vegetable crops are attacked, but some are favored over others. These include broccoli, Brussels, cabbage, cauliflower, collard, kale, kohlrabi, mustard, radish, turnip, and water crisps. Several wild species in the family also act as host, especially early in the season when cultivated crops are unavailable. The egg-laying females have been reported to recognize certain chemicals in the host plants, glucosinolates and isothiocyanates that are characteristics of the Brassicaceae family, but also occur in some related families. Larvae damage leaves, buds, flowers and seed buds of cultivated cruciferous plants. Although the larvae are small, they can be very numerous and cause complete removal of foliar tissue except for the leaf veins. The diamondback moth is considered a pest in areas that do not experience very cold winters, as these help to kill off overwintering moths. Control used to be through the use of chemical insecticides, but in the 1980s, resistance to the pyrethroids developed, and soon afterwards, virtually all insecticides became ineffective. A decrease in insecticide use, and particularly elimination of pyrethrinoid use, can help by favoring survival of the parasitoids. Diadema insulariae and Diadomus subtilicornis. The parasitoids Cotacea plutellae is reared in laboratories and released for the control of diamondback moth as part of integrated pest management programs in several countries. Diadema mollifera is another parasite of the moth. The diamondback moth was the first insect found to have become resistant to biological control by the Bt toxin Bacillus thuringiensis. In the field, Trichophilus knee cabbage looper is the only other insect to have developed resistance to Bt toxin in agriculture systems, specifically in greenhouses. The cotton bollworm, corn earworm, or old world African bollworm, Helicoverpa armizera, also known as the scare bordered straw in the UK, where it is an immigrant, is a moth the larvae of cotton bollworm, of which feed on a wide range of plants, including many important cultivated crops. It is a major pest in cotton and one of the most polyphagous and cosmopolitan pest species. It should not be confused with the similarly named related species Helicoverpa zea. The female cotton bollworm can lay several hundred eggs distributed on various parts of the plant under favorable conditions. The eggs can hatch into larvae within 3 days, and the whole life cycle can be completed in just over a month. The eggs are spherical, 0.4 to 0.6 millimeter in diameter, and have a costate surface. They are white, later becoming greenish. The larvae take 13 to 22 days to develop, reaching up to 40 mm long in the sixth instar. Their coloring is variable, but mostly greenish and yellow to red brown. The head is yellow with several parts. Three dark strips extended along the dorsal side and one yellow light strip is situated under the spiracles of the lateral side. The ventral parts of the larvae are pale. They are rather aggressive. Occasionally, carnivorous and many even cannibalize each other. If disturbed, they fall from the plant and crawl upon the ground. The pupae develop inside the silken cocoon over 10 to 15 days in soil at a depth of 4 to 10 centimeters or in cotton balls of the maize ears. The cotton bollworm is a highly polyphagous insect. The most important crop crops are tomato, cotton, pigeon pea, chickpea, sorghum, and cowpea. Other oats include groundnut, okra, peas, field beans, soya beans, phallus species, other leguminaceae, tobacco, potato, maize, a number of fruit trees, forest trees, and a range of vegetable crops. In Russia and adjacent countries, the larvae populate more than 120 plant species, favoring solanum, datura, hyoscyamus, atriplex, and amaranthus genera. Economic significance. The greatest damage is caused to cotton, tomatoes, maize, chickpeas, alfalfa, and tobacco. The economic threshold of harmfulness in Central Asia is 3 to 5 larvae per 100 plants of long staple cotton and 8 to 12 larvae per 100 plants of medium staple cotton. In cotton crops, blooms that have been attacked many open prematurely and stay fruitless. When the balls are damaged, some will fall off and others will fail to produce lint or produce lint of an inferior quality. Secondary infections by fungi and bacteria are common and may lead to rottening of fruits. Injury to the growing tips of the plants may disturb their development. Maturity may be delayed and the fruits may be dropped. Control measures include the use of Nacotov-V, adulticide, attract and kill formulations, growing of resistant varieties, weeding inter-row cultivation, removing crop residues, deep autumn plowing, winter watering to destroy the pupae, the use of insecticides or biological control through the release of entomophagous such as Trichogramma species and Arbocorn inhibitor monitoring is possible by the use of sex hormone traps. Development of BT cotton genetically modified to produce Bacillus thuringiensis toxin improved yields in lint. Thank you.